Hello, and welcome to Hindsight 101, where you learn about things that will help you in everyday life. Now, if you want to know the many different ways to set up your home internet, I have all the details for you. And if you like my content, hit subscribe. And if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Thanks a lot. Now let's get to it.
Hello, I'm Derek, and let's talk about how we can set up your home internet. There are many different ways, and I know it can be confusing, so I'm going to walk you through all the different devices that you can use to set it up, and then you can choose which one would be best for your situation. So let's get started. First, we're going to talk about the modem. The modem is pretty much a connection between your ISP, Internet Service Provider, and your home. There are many different ones you can get based off your needs. You can get one like this where it's just a modem, or you can get a combo unit that has router and modem functions built in together. So let's talk about the connections. So as you can see here, there are only a few connections that you have to worry about. First, the Ethernet connection, which you would use an Ethernet cable. It looks something like this. It just looks kind of like a big telephone cord, but it's not. And you would plug this into this jack right here. And then the other end of that, you would use that to plug into one device, maybe a laptop or a computer. But if you want to go to multiple devices, that's when you're going to need a router. And we'll talk about that next. But once you have this all set up, some may have this, some may not. This is more just for diagnostic purposes, so you won't really use this. And then here, the coax connection, you're going to hook this up from the coax line that's coming out of the wall. And this should be the coax line that's linked directly to the outside box installed by your cable provider. So you can't hook this up to just any coax line in your house. You have to make sure it's the main one. And this is just a regular coax cable. You've all seen them before. This is what you would use to plug into the back of this. As I said before, it would be coming straight out of the wall. And then finally, this is just the power. You'd plug your power cord into right here. One thing to note, if you are installing your own modem and not having the cable technician to install it for you, they're going to need to know your MAC address. And usually that's at the bottom or the back of your modem. And you just give them those numbers on the back and they can put it into their system so your modem talks with their system. Next, we'll talk about the router. The router's function is to give internet either wirelessly or wired to every device in your home. I like to use the analogy of an apartment. An apartment building has an address, but each apartment has their own apartment number. And that's what a router does. It assigns every device in your home an apartment number. So you have your main IP address at your home, all the other different IP addresses for all the devices in your home, and that's essentially what the router does for you. Now there's many different types of routers you can get. You can get ones that have antennas on them, like so, or you can get ones without. I prefer ones with antennas because that will give you the most range. You can get the ones that have internal antennas, but they may or may not be as good depending on the brand that you get. So it may look ugly, but it will be more reliable. As you can see on the back, it has a lot of different connections. So here you can see, this is where you plug in your power. And then next, it has an on-off switch, so you can turn it on and off. Not all of them have it, but the majority do. Also, you have a USB option. With this, you can plug in a printer, but then others is mostly used for storage. You can have your own little cloud storage within your home. Next, you have the reset button, if for some reason you need to reset. And then here, this blue one right here, you'll always have a single and then a couple of Ethernet ports to the side. The usual one that's a single, that's the one that you're going to connect from that single Ethernet jack that's in the modem. You connect that into here. If you plug it into here, it won't work correctly. These jacks over here are so you can provide a wired connection to, say, a TV, a streaming device, a printer, whatever you want. And then you also have the function of having a wireless connection. Most routers sold today will have a 2.4 and a 5G wireless signal. Every device now will support the 2.4. You may have some legacy devices that don't support 5G, but that's fine. It's not really a problem. But know that you do have those two options available depending on what type of setup you have in your home. So now we'll talk about a switch and what a switch does. A switch will pretty much give you extra ports that your router does not have. So we saw before the router only had 4 ports. Once you use up those 4 ports, you're kind of out of luck. So this is where a switch comes in. It'll give you more ports to share more hardwired connections in your home. This is different from a router where I told you have that one port that you have to put the connection in and the other ones are the spares. Well, with the switch, it doesn't matter. You can plug the cable coming from the router in any one of these ports and it'll work just the same. But they're very simple. You just the power on and off, and then you have your plug. With these, you have lights on the front that kind of tells you the activity. They'll blink when things are plugged in and it's sending and receiving information. This is what they call an unmanaged switch. You can get a managed switch as well, which basically, if you don't know what to get the unmanaged switch. If you like to do a lot of tinkering and you're doing a lot of different things where you have to know what's going on with each one of these ports or a lot of other advanced features, then I would get a managed switch, but no, they're also more expensive as well. So if you just want a simple setup, you just need more ports from the back, then just get an unmanaged switch. And if you don't know the difference between the two, if it doesn't say managed, it probably isn't. Now let's talk about extenders. And what extenders are, they'll give you a wireless signal where maybe you wouldn't be able to get with just your normal router. And how that works is, say you have your router at one end of the house, and then you want to get this other room that's on the other end of the house a wireless connection or a wired connection, you can use this. And how it works is you would just simply plug this into the wall as normal, and then you would have to take an Ethernet cord, plug it into here, and then the other end you would plug into a computer, a laptop, whatever, and you'd have to go into the configuration and set it up so it would connect to your wireless network. And once you've done that, you have a wireless extender. And what it will do is it'll extend the signal to that part of the house. The bad part about this is when you're extending a wireless signal, you lose half of your speed. So whatever speed that you're getting from your router, cut that in half. But the other thing is, if you're getting a bad connection, you're just going to extend another bad connection. So what you want to do is make sure this is placed in kind of the middleman between your router and the bad connection. So somewhere in the middle here. You don't want to put it close to that bad, to that area where you want, because and then you'll just be extending a bad connection and that defeats the purpose. And then also, once you're done configuring it, you can also use this port as a hardwired connection as well. In that aspect, you won't lose any speed. This is also an extender. I just wanted to show you the different options. This one has a touch screen, so it'll work a little bit better for you, whereas some of the other ones you have to plug in and you have to configure with the configurations. And this one, you can just tap it and go to where you want. So that's always a plus. They also make routers like this as well. They're a little more expensive, but if you don't like going into the actual settings, or say you were somewhere where you didn't have access to a laptop or computer to hook up to this, then you could actually just go through the touchscreen and configure it just like that. So you have a couple different options. Next, we're going to talk about MOCA, Media Over Coax Alliance. And basically what this does, uses your existing coax hookups throughout your house to transmit an internet signal, which is great because many of us already have coax cable running throughout our homes. It's pretty basic. So what you would do, you have to have two of these. And how it works is you would take the coax from the wall, the one that's going to your TV, and you plug it in here, and then you plug this other one out to the TV so you can still get a cable signal to your TV. But then in one of these ports, you would hook up to your router. You can use any one of them. You would hook up the Ethernet cord to your router. That would give it a signal. Now the second one would be in a bedroom or wherever that you want this hardwired connection to go. And then you would do the same thing. If you still want to use your TV, you take the cable out of the wall, put it into here, and then you would put this TV out. If you don't need to hook it up to a TV, then this TV out is useless and you can just plug it straight into the cable in. And then at that point, you have two connections. And then now this is active and you can just use these Ethernet ports to have a hardwired connection to whatever you want. Of course, you have to have power. Forgot to mention that. And then here on the front, the lights will light up to tell you that there's activity, there's power. They work really well. So now you have Powerline. And what Powerline does is it uses your existing electrical wiring to transmit an internet signal. And how these work are, one, you have to plug it directly into the wall. You cannot plug it into a surge protector or an extension cord. It will mess up with the connection. But once you do that, you have it plugged into the wall, you plug the Ethernet cord into here, and then the other end goes into your router. And then you take the second unit and you plug that to wherever, another bedroom. You wanna plug that into the wall, and then you would take an Ethernet cord and then plug that into whatever device you want. Say a switch if you want more hardwired connections, or you can just plug it into a computer or whatever device, streaming device, whatever you want. The good thing about these is you have encryption. Some of them don't, but the majority of them do. And the reason why I say that, if you're in your home encryption doesn't really matter. If you're in an apartment building with a lot of electrical wiring that's connected, someone could, maybe above you, below you, next to you, could get one of these as well, and then they could actually tap into your home network. So you want to make sure if you're in that type of environment, you have encryption. You don't really have to have the same brand or the same speed to hook up. So you can have many different ones connected to this. I have a Zyxel, but you can get other brands and it would connect to this brand as well, 9 times out of 10. The only downfall about if you get ones with different speeds is whichever unit has the lowest speed, that's what all of them will have. These are really good, but I consider them a last resort because they have the most interference. One, these have to be on the same circuit. They may work on different circuit breakers, but through my experiences, I haven't had any luck. You just need to make sure these are on the same circuit in order for them to work. The other downfall is a lot of interference. Say you have something that draws a lot of power, like a blender or anything like that. If they're on the same circuit, that could affect the speeds. These are a last resort, but everybody has electrical wiring in their house, so they're also the most convenient.